Boys and girls, welcome back.
Boys and girls?
No.
That's how I do my intro.
I love it.
Do you really?
It's okay. I just wanted to know.
Okay.
You can keep that in.
You can keep going? That, yeah. Okay. Boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from Winter NAMM in the Paul Reed Smith. And it's not the Paul Reed Smith booth. We are actually upstairs in the Paul Reed Smith.
Russian front.
This is where we have a sound stage, and this is where all the magic happens during the show, right?
Well, there's a lot of gifted artists. I mean, you have somebody like Martin Simpson and Tony McManus and Cody playing. Something's magic's going to happen. It's just
right.
They're that good.
Right.
And David Grissom was up here playing, and the Granger Brothers are up here, and it's been fun. Mm-hmm. By the way, this is NAMM 2012. I want you to know that the years are going by so fast, it's unbelievable.
It is. How many NAMMs have you been to?
22
NAMMs. This is my third.
Yeah.
So what have you
well,
seen?
Well, you're doing better 3 years in than I'm doing 22 in. So
what have you seen in 22 years worth of change, like at a high level? What are some of the things that you've seen change?
I've seen a lot change, but I would like to go over a much larger time frame, if that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
So when I'm 55 years old. So when I was a kid, there were maybe 10 guitar companies max.
Mm-hmm.
Now there's 250. But there's still only really 10, 12 manufacturers. So the problem is that there's a huge amount of people just ordering guitars with logos on them from these mass manufacturers. And it's hard for your viewers to know what to believe. In a way, that's why your thing exists, because people want to know what the truth is, right? And it's really difficult, really, really difficult for people to swim through the mud, because it's so confusing. Stores are mostly full of imitations of what we loved when we were kids. When I was a kid, it was all the real deal, you know? And so that has changed immensely. But I was in diapers in 1958, so I wasn't invited to that party. That was a hell of a party. You know, the advent of Fender and Gibson and Gretsch and, you know, Marshall and, God, all these great companies, you know, Neumann, all these wonderful companies built their legacies, right?
Mm-hmm.
So for us, we're not trying to recreate the past. We're trying to do something special in the moment. And so for us, we're three companies. We're a guitar company. We have our private stock and regular and SE guitars. We're an amp company. We have our CAD amps, which are private stock, regular, and SEs. And we have acoustics in the same way, private stock and regular,
sure,
and SEs. And so there are three tiers of three different companies. And it seems to be going pretty well. We're growing, even in these really awful economic times. We're growing. So for me, if people could separate, you know, what's real and what's a piece of gear that's going to be held as an extraordinary piece of gear in 20 years, and what is something that will, you know, almost end up rotting in a garage, separating this stuff is hard to do. And in a way, as the press, it's your job, and in a way, it's my job to try to explain all that. But
sure,
I see a huge amount of change, the biggest change being that it's a very crowded market.
So in a vision, and you said a lot of the things you do, you started with guitars and now you do acoustics, you have the amplifier line. From a vision, if you could look 20 years ahead, where do you think you'll be then?
Traveling with my wife.
Nice. Okay, that's a good answer.
My hair is white,
mm-hmm,
and I'm starting to lose it. I'm growing a yarmulke on the back side. And, you know, I would like to travel with her in 10 years. I would like to spend some time doing that. I'm sure I'll always be involved in guitars and amplifiers my whole life. We're actually making basses now, too. But you ask me, that's almost a personal question, you know. When are you going to retire? When are you going to travel? You know,
it's more of the legacy of PRS and Paul Reed Smith product. Where do you see that going?
I don't exactly know, but let's look in the rearview mirror, because sometimes you know the best way to go forward. Stradivari and all these other guys experimented till they were my age, and then they did the same thing over and over and over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
All right, same thing. You know, once the Stratocaster was invented, they kept making them, right? Once the reason Les Paul became the SG is all the artists told them it was too heavy.
Mm.
They were trying to solve a problem. So to me, hopefully the song is written and now you have to just, it's like going on tour and playing the tune. You know, once Joni Mitchell wrote Paved Paradise, she's got to go play it over and over again, right? Same thing for us. So I think the song is written with the amps and the acoustics and the guitars. Things are settling down to a place where I think I'm comfortable with it. And, you know, for me, it's going to be doing a really good job reproducing in a, you know, loving way the instruments that we've designed and worked so hard on.
Nice.
An amplifier is a, it's an instrument. Actually, there's so many parallels in an amp to guitars, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, I agree. In fact, you know, an amp could make or break your sound. You know,
there
is synergy. You have to have the...
Anything.
How are the amps doing? That's relatively new.
It's getting better.
It's
getting better by the day.
Really?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, the amps this year sound better than the ones last year. And an amplifier is a modulated power supply. And we're getting good at it, finally. But it takes a while. You got to swim in a river for a long time. If you want to catch a fish in a river, find the old man that's been in that river his whole life, and you will catch fish.
Right.
Same thing for us. We need to... be in the river enough and talk to the guys who did it, and if they're not alive, you can get what they made and it will talk to you. I've made my living that way. So what's the future? I hope that what we make in 20 years is what we're making now.
Nice. No, that sounds fantastic. I mean, so for 2012, is there a piece of gear?
No, it's tons of it. There's a P22, which is a Piezo 22 fret guitar. We've got our new Signature Limited. There's a whole bunch of new CAD amplifiers, Blister Tones, HXDAs, MDTs. We've got our SE Acoustics. There's a new Cody Kilby acoustic. Here, we just walk over right here. Here's the new Cody Kilby acoustic that we're making. This is the Neil Sean guitar that we're going to release tomorrow, private stock. This is a Paul Jackson Jr. J15. There's a lot. This is the P22, the Piezo guitar that I was talking about. We have lots of new stuff. But it's gentle and strong modifications of what we've done in the past.
Okay, excellent. Well, I want to thank you very much
for making
the time.
No
I appreciate
problem.
It very much.
No problem.
I hope you have a great show.
How many people are going to watch this? Don't laugh. Well,
how many people?
I wanna
you want me to give you some quick stats?
No, just give me the stat. How many people are going to watch this?
In the next 24 hours, we'll probably hit 1,000, maybe a couple of thousand.
Yeah.
Over the course of 12 months, it could be upwards of maybe 10 to 12,000.
That's great. That's great. So, look, everybody watching, thanks for watching. We make gear.
Right.
And we don't put war wounds in babies. Now, what I mean by that is if you take a guitar and you put a bunch of war wounds in it, all right, you're trying to make it look old, but it's brand new.
Right.
We don't do that. You buy a piece of gear from us, you put the war wounds in it.
Nice.
All right.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Have a great NAMM show.
All right. Thank you so much. All right. Bye-bye.